We open tonight's concert with Václav Nellie Bell's Festivo. Written in 1968, Nellie Bell describes it as an overture-type composition in which the woodwinds and brasses are constantly confronting each other like two antagonists in a dramatic scene. The brass begin with fanfare-like figures, while the woodwinds answer with more lyrical chorale-like passages. The two groups switch roles throughout the first two-thirds of the piece. The finale begins with a soft woodwind chorale that builds in momentum to the last note where every section finally comes together.
Thank you. 5 instead of a more customary 3 feel. Similarly, the march features a steady pulse and bold fanfares, but alternates between sections of 5 and 7. As is a customary with multi-movement works, we ask that you please hold your applause until the end of the march. We hope you enjoy Third Suite.
Thank you. George Washington, a bicentennial commission was formed in Washington, D.C. in 1932. A gala celebration was held in his honor, culminating in an impressive ceremony at the Capitol Plaza. The commission asked Sousa to take part in the final ceremony, where this march was premiered by the combined bands of the United States Army, Navy, and Marine Corps. This is the George Washington Bicentennial March by John Philip Sousa.
Scottish folk songs. Here is Samuel Hazo's for Sovereign Majesty.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much. Before our final number of the evening already, just wanted to say a few words. So first off, I am not Mr. Inandino and Mr. Graffio, obviously. So Mr. Graffio is sick this evening, so we wish him well. That's why he is not here tonight. But on behalf of him, I just wanted to thank our students for all their hard work over the course of this semester so far. It's been a very busy semester between pep band and jazz and our chamber groups that have been meeting over the last several weeks and months here. It's been a very busy time, and on top of all of that and their score, the students have been working just so hard on the repertoire tonight and as well as things to come. So thank you to our students, and thank you to all of you for your support. It's a great audience for a great cause, so thank you so much for coming out this evening. Let's give it up for all. I do also want to thank, I believe, District 211 Board of Education President Anna Klunkowitz is in the audience, so thank you, Mrs. Klunkowitz. She is up top. Thank you so much for your support. So I do want to recognize a few students, and you have seen some things probably in your program if you took a look there. So we did have a number of students who participated in this year's District 211 Honors Orchestra. So I believe we had 20 Saxons between the band and orchestra programs here, which I believe is a record for us, and it was the largest group representing District 211 at the festival. So if you were a member of the District 211 Honors Orchestra, can you please stand and be recognized? District 211 Honor Band that is being hosted at Schaumburg High School. So 2 o'clock on Saturday, the 211 Honor Band will be performing a concert. We'd love to see you here as well for that. We do have a number of Saxons. I believe there's 24 of them who are participating in the 211 Honor Band. So if you are an Honor Band member this year, please stand and be recognized. We had four students who participated in the ILMEA All-State Conference and the All-State Festivals that happened back at the end of January. So we wanted to recognize those students. So I'm going to ask each of these students to come up and receive their commemorative plaque. These students will also be displayed on the ILMEA All-State Musician display that's just outside the auditorium foyer as you walk in. Our first student here from the All-State Band on flute, Mr. Ramsey Barlow. All right, from the Honor Band on horn, Reese Barlow. Band on baritone saxophone, Josephine Mascarenhas. And from the All-State Band on bass clarinet, Jenna Valoria. So we do have a very busy couple of weeks coming up here. So after this concert, on Tuesday, we do have our music department chamber night. So this is the first time that we are doing this across band, orchestra, and choir. We're going to have two recitals, one at 6 o'clock and one at 7:30, that are going to feature a lot of the performances that students brought to our in-house solo and ensemble a few weeks ago, as well as IHSA solo and ensemble that happened just this past weekend. So that's coming up next week, and then when we get back in April, we have our Chicagoland Invitational Concert Band Festival, which both the Wind Symphony and Symphonic Band will be performing at. We also have the musical coming up, and then our awards concerts to finish the year. So lots of great things, including that District 211 Honor Band concert coming up on Saturday, so we hope you will join us again. So we have one more piece for you, so I'm going to let Josephine introduce that, then we're going to take one more tuning note, since you guys have been sitting for a while, and then we'll close with that.
My name is Josephine Mascarenas, and I play the alto saxophone. In 1948, H. Owen Reed spent 6 months in Mexico while on a Guggenheim Fellowship, during which time he studied folk music and composed. La Fiesta Mexicana, a Mexican folk song symphony for concert band, was a result of his time in the country and reflects his observations of the culture. Reed used authentic folk tunes that can be heard in Chapala, Jalisco, and Guadalajara, with other themes borrowed from Gregorian motifs and Aztec dances. In Reed's words, the third movement, Carnival, reflects the entertainment for both young and old. The itinerant circuits, the market, the bullfight, the town band, and always the cantinas with their band of mariachis. This is Carnival from H. Owen Reed's La Fiesta Mexicana.
Thank you.
Thank you.